All right, guys, so welcome back to the Balance Diet Entertainment this morning. Now, if you check your Google, you can see the level we're on top. Now, the one we're consigned this top story will be the current situation report of the ban of Okada and Keke Napep for inside certain places for Lagos State. Now, 15 local governments are in the affected, and they will take effect since February 1 of 2020, will be Saturday. Now, we're asking you for this. So, what do you think about how, more importantly, how you even done they manage the ban this Okada and Keke Napep for these areas for inside Lagos State? Now, if you don't stay Lagos before and you don't move from what, you feel still tell us what you think about the report. And you were there out there, how you don't they manage? Has it been easy? Has life been a little better? And transportation, it don't increase for you? Or even get it to work, it don't they as easy as it's supposed day? Well, not be only you and I go chook mouth. We also get an analyst in the building. We go also chook mouth on top of this one. Now, him, a very familiar face. We've done the on top of our couch a couple of times in the past, especially when it comes to things we concern politics and other things we concern our country. Helping me welcome this morning, Najib Bello in the building. Good morning, Najib.
Thank you. Good morning, Jerry.
Now, make I first ask, how was it coming from where you did come from? So, when after Lekki, coming to the Wazobia TV studio, how the road be day?
Traffic not be smart, you know. I leave house around, say, 5:30. And even to get here now, the last, like, 15 minutes, I get to run, go here, jump Okada here, enter.
Were you able to take Okada?
Off the road, you know, through back of Lekki, near that Chisco or Ikate, get where you fit take Okada, inside, not on the express. So they not totally ban Okada from the entire area. Then ban them from major roads. And you know those major roads, now them really link. I know if you take Okada, right now, I know if you take Okada from Aja to this place. Before, if I they come here, I get confidence, even within 1 hour, if I reach anywhere way, motor no fit move again, I enter Okada. But with this new ban now, I spend almost, how many hours? About 2.5 hours, just from around the Brahma, this Sonya, to this place.
To get to the Wazobia TV?
Yeah, the normal traffic where they did Lekki Express, they start around Igbo Efon up to Jakonde. Once you pass Jakonde, you are free. But from around, just before Chevron, the toll gate before Chevron, yes. 90, the main traffic start today.
Wow.
From there up to this Ikate. Traffic still there for the mirror.
Wow. So, now, looking at the current situation of things, and people, they come outside, because we get a lot of messages on top of WhatsApp machine, and people, they come outside, they talk from different angles. Some people, they come outside, they talk, say, why the government no create alternative
for
these people?
You see, government don't fail. The issue of transportation, they don't totally fail. Look the Lekki Express with just one road from Sangotedo to VI, just one road. They say they go build road for the beach side, where go be one of the alternatives. They never build. It's almost 10 years they only talk about that. You know, that's failure. The light rail, I mean blue rail, where they done they build since around 2009 or so, where they say they'll finish by up to today. They never even reach half. Fort Milan Bridge, where they only talk since 2007, up to today. So all these things we suppose is traffic. We they not do, nine cause the failure of traffic in Lagos. Now, Okada come as a shabby solution. It's not a perfect solution to the traffic problem. And instead of make them come put the real solution on ground, if they put, when BRT come, a lot of us leave Molue. They don't need to flog the Molue people or harass anybody. When we see ACBRT at the same price with all those Molue boys, oh, they sweat, and then we move, go BRT. So it's just like the situation within the crate now, just be like as hospitals no day Nigeria, not enough hospital, everything. Then midwives, they go help women deliver pikin. Then you just vex, you know, provide new hospitals, you know, doing, you just ban the midwives, say no, they no sabi work. How you want me people manage?
Now, make I come from the Lagos State government's point of view, because, I mean, you, they talk for the people. I want to talk for the Lagos State government.
Yes.
Now, according to certain reports, what they hear from top social media, what they hear say one of the reasons, now, because of the way where they take ride on top of this road. Now, a lot of times people don't experience, I know I don't even also experience them, the way where some Keke Napep, sometimes they won't compete
with cars.
Sometimes they cause certain kind of traffic because if you just stop, they almost behave like Danfo. Where Danfo will just stop for middle of the road.
Now
make we talk, now that's for the Keke Napep. For the Okada, a lot of young boys from the northern part of Nigeria, they come Lagos because we know, say, Lagos is one of the commercial hub of the nation. And these people, with little or no experience, they give them Okada. So they are, the way where they ride this Okada, if they put lives of the person that they carry for back, if they put those lives at risk. So now, these are some of the angles where the government come to reduce the level of accidents on top of the roads.
Now, not the issue of ban, Nango Sov, and the thing where you talk about recklessness, they true. Then bring out some data. We then show how many people don't get accident or die from Okada. Now, I look at the data. How many thousands of people did they talk about? Compared to motor accident, people where they die for motor accident, can you, if you compare them? So if they, they get maybe 700 deaths per year from Okada, and they get like 5,000 deaths per year for cars, why they no cuckoo ban car too? So we know, say, there are issues with these Okada people. Some of them no get training, like we talk, but organizations, they, where they train people. Government, if you talk, say, if you no get so-so and so training and certification, you know if you ride Okada. That is what in the people they talk, say, regulate. Now, we get all this Gokada. We get Max Okada. We get all the OP and the rest. We be say, them, they come. They train people. They certify them. They give them insurance. They do everything to make sure, say, these people, they do the Okada business, right? Government ban all of them. So where the sense? If you talk, say, government, they try reduce accidents. They try reduce all the nonsense where they do for traffic. These people, we don't come, where they arrange things, where they train the driver as well, they equip them, give them a helmet, make sure so they don't carry more than one passenger. Why the same government go ban them? So now waiting, we want make government explain, give us.
So now where government don't place this ban, and the private sector, just those companies we don't mention, they come outside also express their shock on top of them, because they come outside talk, say, they were not carried along.
Yes, then they always try to discuss with government, but government will just come
as at the time when
while,
government, as at the time when they hear the pronouncement, say they were not carried along. And as investors, we don't come as where the government actually they encourage for more investment to come into the country. This is not an encouragement on the part of the government to the investors. Also, they also come outside, they talk other angles to where people, they come outside, they agree to. And I know, say, as at last week Friday, there was a protest, a peaceful, a very peaceful protest with Bishele for inside Ikeja Axis, where I be there, I know, say, I be witness them. And some of these men, they actually carry different placards talking about how and why they shouldn't be banned as well. Now, let's look at the solution. Let's look at, we understand, so we get the problem. We understand, say, government don't do something which should have been right, but it didn't come at the right time.
Yes.
Now, make we look the solution. Which other alternative? Make we assume, say, this ban on the ground and there's nothing anybody can do about it. What do you feel, say, the government fit to do or individuals fit to do to create? Because now some people, they talk, say, they should have created an alternative source for these people now because they're reducing their revenue. What we fit to do from individuals to government to create alternative jobs?
Jobs.
People.
the thousands of Okada people.
You cannot be only Okada or that they've been affected.
Yeah,
people they fix Okada.
Of course, the
will be
whole
affected.
Value
the whole
chain of
system.
Suppliers,
yes, the suppliers
or dealers,
importers,
and everything.
Everybody is affected.
You see, for now, if we say this ban must hold, which I no go support at all, but if we say this ban must hold, the solutions where government fee bring now, then go be long term solutions where go take effect maybe by 2022. Say you won't build Fort Mellan Bridge or you won't complete the rail. Or, because for cars to move, you know, if you have one expressway, almost 50 kilometer expressway, we'll be saying now only one every car. So you have to get alternative routes where then go fee pass. But the main thing where government is supposed to do now, water transport. The people where they use ferries, if you go, you see some of the ferries where they use. I don't go before. I won't use ferry from Ajah side to Ikorodu. When I go there, I see the boat where we won't enter. I turn back, enter main road, begin go around. So the first thing where they go do, put proper boats. And I know they talk about, say, they put 10 boats or they put 15 boats. They talk about hundreds of boats all across Lagos. We go, they move people from Ikoyi to here, from Ikorodu to here. That is one of the main solutions which they never even feel do. So simple. You don't need to build road. You don't need to build track. Just build the boat or even encourage people where they do the private sector now. They're not even they sure, say, tomorrow, if they begin investing in boats, government no go come one day, come ban them or put one huge tax on them. That's waiting they even scare people because the way government they operate, now they worry people the most. You they do something, government will just look, say, oh, okay, they will just leave you, they do. you they do everything right. One day government will just come till they don't ban you. So the main thing with the fee do, if they won't keep the ban on Okada right now, the first thing they go do is within the next 3 months, either they themselves or through some other agreement, put a lot of boats around, standard boats, not the kind nonsense we will get right now. We'll be saying if you enter, you're not sure whether you go reach where they go. So water transport now, one place where Lagos shamefully just leave anyhow. So they need to take care of that. Then on the long term, then those bridges where they're supposed to be, those alternative routes, all of them, we don't, they almost, more than 10 years now, when they talk about rail for Lagos, more than 10 years when they talk about Fort Mainland Bridge, when they talk about alternative routes here and there.
Well, let's not forget, say, even though we don't say this project, this infrastructure we talk about, it is very important and it is very necessary. Mm. And we can also forget, say, even the federal government, they complain, say, funds, not readily they are available. Mm. Now, we know, say, for some of these projects, like the rail project, World Bank, you have a contract mark, that's why they also give us money to fund those particular projects. And we know, say, if you're looking at the railway now, I mean, it almost looks like an abandoned project if you go there physically, go see them. Now, these are long-term projects. We they talk of, like you talk, it will take time.
Exactly.
In the interim, we need something feasible. If you
now
work,
I talk, say, in, the that's the way you talk, say, do, the water transport
but is
the best thing with the transport.
You still get plenty, comma.
Yeah, because some people, you get weird that they dredge. You know, you go enter some kind of water, it's supposed to be shallow water. Somebody don't go dredge sand, come up for the place. You enter there, you know, no direction. Water has sent everywhere. Government themselves, they know they clear. Government said, go dredge. We're supposed to be waterway. You get places where it's supposed to be waterway around, all those Ilubiru and everything. Government said, go authorize people to dredge, fill and build house. So, for now, because they don't get any real short term solution, for now, they need to unban the Okada, especially the ones where we say, now corporate organizations, we don't structure their system, don't give people, train people, don't, you know, I don't even understand how they take come this decision. Maybe they need to show us exactly how they take. Reach the decisions we then reach. But this Okada ban right now, it don't make any sense. Today na Monday, today not be the worst traffic day, but the traffic out there, they mad. By Friday, now don't tell people, say now by Friday, now we go really know the effect of this Okada ban. So for now, make them try fix water transport. Get and investors, they worry investors with the kind moves where they make.
It's quite
because nobody know. Give Fort Mainland Bridge, if investor come now and say, won't build Fort Mainland Bridge, tomorrow, another governor, another person will come from nowhere say, no, they don't ban this, they don't cancel that. So, you know, give people confidence.
All right, we'll not say people don't, or they also choke mouth on top. This one, we get Solomon from Lagos, where they talk, say, you know, like within government they do, because people, they use keke, they chop for inside Lagos. It's a source of livelihood, just as we talk. And now, that source of livelihood has been shortened.
We they talk of loss of jobs, yes. Now, one of the things we don't, they affect us for like almost 3-4 years now. Nigeria don't lose lots of jobs. That is one of the reasons why people, they enter all these alternatives. Nobody go university, go study Okada riding or Keke Marwa riding. But now because they don't, they push their CV. I they tell you truth, say, you get people who finish school before 2010, we never get formal job. We finish university before 2010, we never get office work do. And these people, they for ground for a long time, then begin do all this hustle. Some of them, you get Okada men, we be say they don't ride for years. They don't even buy another Okada, give somebody where they ride for them. They don't get like fleet of like 3-4.
Oh, yes, we don't interview some. We come outside and talk,
exactly.
They don't want to even do office work. Because they are already comfortable.
Exactly.
And
they don't build house in their own business. Some of them don't build house. Not maybe for Lekki or somewhere, but all those Ibeju, Lekki or Mowe area. They don't build house. They don't train their children and go university. So how you go just wake up one day, just erase jobs, hundreds of thousands of jobs, just like that. When you know if you create 10,000 jobs, in a day, you just wipe out almost 100,000 jobs. In 1 month, you know if you create 10,000 jobs.
All right, while still looking at that one and looking at the ban on top and ban and restriction on top of Okada and Mara, we'll also enter the other ban, talking about United States and Nigeria and this visa restriction ban. But you wait out there, don't forget to send me your message on top of the WhatsApp machine, maybe 0809-032-1452. How you take which walk this morning? Now, moving away from there, we know say that will never end, but let's look at this visa restriction and ban where the United States don't come outside, put Nigeria, in addition to 5 other countries, Kazakhstan, they for there, Tanzania, they for there, yeah, amongst other countries. And based on, according to information they get now, they talk, say, Nigeria, no, they follow the standard in terms of sharing of information, safety information. information about potential terrorists who want to enter inside their country. Those are some of the reasons where they don't use, they justify themselves as the need to put Nigeria as part of the countries to put in terms of the visa ban and restriction.
We get all those challenges in terms of data.
But those reasons, are they justifiable?
Well, they are. They really are.
They really?
There are people who get people where they go from Nigeria to Yankee, where we say then go just sit down, fabricate information about themselves, their tax payments. They could just go one place, go pay somebody something, could just create tax document, give them, put like how many million inside their account. Something we know exists before, they'll just create new profile, use them, enter Yankee. And for Nigeria, those people, Yankee government, no even fit come Nigeria, can't say, okay, where our data, they say, who be this person? How many years in don't do this, really? We know if we back them up. Even us, for our own data, we know if we do anything. Our SIM registration, all the information we government don't gather, BVN, everything, they know if we use them, say, oh, this person we don't identify. If we fight crime like this for Nigeria, then if you say, oh, waiting be this person's SIM card number. Okay, waiting be in bank ID. Oh, from here, we fit track, say, okay, now here in day, or in withdraw money for all those information just discarded. They don't even fit link everything together. Police, now 2018, at the end of 2018, nine police, they say then they set up data center. Something we suppose done day since 1960 or so. So there is no fingerprint for you and I now. There is no fingerprint where police get for us. Where if we commit crime somewhere, they feel so. So, and that, now those things, now in the US government, they work with. Now, the main problem for this visa ban, now the kind of ambassador where we get for US, then put one grandpapa away there about 80-something years, where he know they agile enough to say, when US ask for information or relations or say, Mo, do this, Ingo, just stand up, where begin, move, begin. That is one of the main problems where I see between Nigeria, US, relationship. If we get active ambassador way they up and doing, the first time we then go, not be now and then just they not be say they just wake up one morning, you know, say Nigeria we ban you for so. Over years then don't they try communicate with us, say, see how we go do this thing, you know. We know if we continue like this, so but us we just stay relaxed because we no get person for there way they up and doing. We go carry the country we get the most Nigerians outside of Nigeria. Most Nigerians outside of Nigeria in one single country, they are in the US. And you put somebody where you say, no, if you just they run from state to state, from here to here, go tackle, how you want to make the country deal with you? So they just say you're on serious with handling issues where they don't bring up to you. So what next? They take drastic action. I sure say,
it's for the benefit of their own citizens.
Exactly.
And they're trying to protect their country and the boundaries.
And I believe, say, as they don't take this drastic action, Nigeria, they always listen to drastic action.
Yeah.
Like that P and ID thing where they give us $9 billion, right. We begin act.
Because of time, I wish we keep you because of time. But thank you so much.
No problem.
Come inside the studio, Neji Bello, an activist, a writer as well.
Yes.
And of course, an analyst, Naibi.
Not
all the time we'll get with this, but thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.